André Malraux, a dominant figure in French politics and culture, predicted,
"From the 20th century in France, three names will remain: Degas, Picasso, and Chanel."
The story of Gabrielle Bonheur Chanel's life is one of rags to riches, a woman taking her place in the men's world of business, and a woman becoming a trendsetter in the male-dominated field of fashion.
Gabrielle was born in Saumur, France. 12 years later, her mother, Jean Chanel, died at age 32, leaving Gabrielle and her other four siblings behind.
Her father, Albert Chanel, abandoned his children and left them in the Avezan orphanage to be raised by nuns. Gabrielle never talked about this era of her life. At the age of 17, Chanel turned down an opportunity to become a seamstress, to become a cabaret singer. This is where she gained her oh-so-famous nickname, Coco.
Coco's relationships with men usually were beneficial to her business. One lucky meeting occurred when she was a cabaret singer and met Etienne Balsan, a Parisian socialite of inherited wealth. Etienne introduced her to Paris's wealthy and influential men and gave her space in his apartment to design and sell her hats. Her hats were well received by their mistresses because Chanel challenged the classical designs of the day. During this time, she also gained connections to Duke Dmitri Pavlovich, Theophile Bader, Pierre Wertheimer, and a self-made man, Captain Arthur Capel.
Capel was so taken with Chanel's business sense that he lent her money to open a hat shop at 31 Rue Cambon in Paris in 1910. Hats were the first step to Chanel's influence in the world of fashion.
Following her success at 31 Rue Cambon with hats, she opened her first dress shop in Indivelle and Biarritz, France. Chanel commented on the fashion of the time,
"I find that women are always overdressed and never elegant enough."
She made clothes that she would like to wear, with inexpensive materials. Her dresses were different because they were loose-fitting and promoted the natural figure of a woman, unlike dresses of the time which caged women in corsets. Her emphasis was placed on how a woman felt in her clothes rather than how they appealed to men.
Because Chanel lived during World War I, there are shortages of traditional fabric used in making women's clothing. This was hardly a struggle for Chanel. She introduced jersey in women's clothing. This contrasted with other notable designers who continue to use expensive fabrics, even in a time of war.
You know, we're all different, so it's nice to have options. As you can see, there's three floors here, and most of the items in this store are for women, you know?
Yeah.
Because of the popularity of her jersey sportswear, jersey created a new option for women.
Other practical creations of Chanel were the cardigan jacket, turtleneck sweater, and the little black dress. These simple designs were more suitable for the working woman and emphasized how fashion isn't all about vanity.
The little black dress became very popular and a staple in every woman's closet.
How do you feel when you wear your little black dress?
I like my little black dress. It's very, boosts my confidence. It's nice. You can wear it anywhere.
The little black dress is a piece that was inspired from visits to Scotland. It is feminine, elegant, flattering, and professional. In a professional setting, it is important to be taken seriously but still feel confident, which the little black dress does for women. During the creation process, Coco commented,
"Women think of all colors except the absence of color. Black has it all."
From her growing popularity in fashion, she became connected to Theophile Bader, the founder of the successful French department store, Galeries Lafayette. He introduced Chanel to Pierre Wertheimer, a well-respected French businessman. Chanel created No. 5 in 1922. Pierre Wertheimer was her partner in the perfume business. The Wertheimer family still owns the house of Chanel, which the perfume company is a part of today.
Oui, je t'aime.
Coco Chanel perfume.
Did you like it?
You know, I did.
Yeah?
I've heard people say that they don't like it,
yeah,
but I did.
Number 5 was the beginning of other well-known Chanel perfumes that women still enjoy.
It's strung, and then they stamp it, and it's still hand-done. We're the only company to do that. And we are also the only company that has fields in Grasse, so 45 minutes after our flowers have been picked, they turn them into the fragrance, and no other company does that. So we're the only company that does that. And we have, that's, yeah. Chanel No. 5 is still number one in the world. It's still number one worldwide after 80 plus years.
And No. 5 is sold every minute of every day.
The most elegant women, such as Marilyn Monroe, Nicole Kidman, and Keira Knightley, were chosen to be symbols of Chanel products and ideals.
I wanna be kissed by you, just you, nobody else but you.
This created a vision of how Chanel's products are for classy, strong, intelligent women. She continued designing and exhibiting in the 30s, expanding her work into lavish jewelry and evening wear. In 1939, at the beginning of World War II, Chanel retired and moved into the Hotel Ritz Paris with Nazi Hans Gunther von Dinklage. France fell under the control of Adolf Hitler in 1940 and made the Hotel Ritz Paris their French headquarters. The Wertheimers fled to the United States and spread rumors that Chanel was a Nazi collaborator. It was said that the Germans sent Chanel to England on a secret mission of peace. When the German occupation ended, Chanel was arrested as a German conspirator. She was released when Winston Churchill intervened on her behalf. She later fled to Switzerland in 45 and stayed there until 54.
In 54 and 56, Chanel returned to fashion with a pea jacket and classic Chanel suit for women because one of her competitors, Christian Dior, created the new look, which included a new version of a corset. The Belle of Redeal, a British representative of Parliament, called Dior's corset an attempt at curtailing women's freedom. The Chanel suit, on the other hand, was to be worn by professional, powerful, independent, working women. The pea jacket and women's suit were the designs that captivated the United States. Most female politicians still wear suits that originated from the Chanel suit.
Gabrielle Coco Chanel died on January 10, 1971. Her funeral was held at the Church of Madeleine in Paris. Artists, socialites, and politicians attended. She commented about her life.
I invented my life by taking for granted that everything I did not like would have an opposite, which I would like.
At the time of her death, Chanel products were sold in 18,000 outlets worldwide, and today, products bearing the name of Chanel sell for $225 to $11,000 and up. Karl Lagerfeld is the chief designer of Chanel. All of his designs focus on updating classic Chanel.
I think Chanel's work is a balancing act between black and red, poverty and luxury, simplicity and splendor.
Slingback heel, the first to do costume jewelry in her fashions. She was the first to do pants for women. Women never wore pants before her. Pockets in a jacket. The first woman to do tanning. A lipstick. She was the first woman to do lipstick in a tube, in a bullet tube. She was the first.
When you say tanning, do you mean?
Women never used to tan.
Oh,
they used to keep
so
their...
Coco gave the fashion industry a vision of what she wanted fashion to be. Her legacy is that fashion was not about status, but about practicality. Chanel designed for working, middle class, and wealthy women. She found a way to cross the barriers of social class with her talented creations.
But Chanel was much more than fashion. She was one of the first huge industry leaders who was not male. The encyclopedia, Great Lives from History, said,
Chanel was the first to dress women in a manner that reflected their increasing liberated status, which began in the first quarter of the 20th century, and she continued to do so for nearly six decades, reigning as queen of fashion in Paris.
According to Chanel, fashion was for women, therefore it should be designed by a woman. Throughout her life, Coco brought women into a modern era of thinking. She broke the boundaries of limitations on women in society. She promoted confidence with her bold personality, free-flowing hems, and independent lifestyle. Since her death, Chanel has received a lot of well-earned recognition. She was listed in Time's Most Influential People of the 20th Century, and the February 2009 issue of Vanity Fair also stated that.
Not even the mythomaniac Gabrielle Coco Chanel could have anticipated how her legacy would persist triumphantly into the next millennium.
Chanel.
Okay.
Well, no, I don't wear Chanel.
You do?
I do. I wear Chanel in the type of you, and I wear makeup.
Really? That's great. Do you like it? Do you think it accents your face nicely?
I like it. I don't know that it accents my face, but I like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I do.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm gonna walk towards you?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Hold on, Rhonda.
Oh,
spin.
Oh yeah, you should spin.